sorry, morning. Alright. Yeah. I guess I just had to get up. So this video is okay. Alright, well, hello guys! I'm back. Again. To do some more Cradle. Frame seems to be a little bit lower than last time. But yeah, I finished the task. I gotta do a few things. She's talked about some lore that I completely forgot about. I might do it all again to figure out what she was talking about. But yeah. Anyway, I got the flowers, I copied them, I put it in there, I did this thing on them. Now I need to go get, I need to go grab a few things. I need to get lens, it's scene module, I think, and yeah, we'll be on our way. Rumpleys, okay. So yeah, now I don't know when Tabaha, that robotic old dude, I don't know when he'll get back though, I'm not completely sure. I did tick him off last episode though by telling him to get a hat, and how his value to society is low, and such. So yeah, I don't think he's gonna arrive anytime soon. But yeah, anyway, I need to go to the Gabura Garden again. Jeez, the frames are low. But I need to go to the Gabura Garden and search for the second Pavilion. Should be easy. Well, let's get this shell on the road. This laggy mess on the road. Alright. Man, the frames are low today. Very low. Oh. Alright, so I guess this is the drop-off area. The area looks really clean, actually. Okay. Sensitivity's going anywhere. Okay. This place actually looks really clean today. Why are the frames so low? Sorry guys, but I have to do this in front of you all of you guys. It's like really laggy today. Or not laggy, but so many low frames. I'm very sorry. I guess I could turn down entire scene by one. That do anything? Okay, I guess we're just gonna have to sit here. That's right, best. I keep on forgetting to start a stopwatch. Okay. Does that help my leggy mess? No, it kind of does. Anyway, so the second pavilion. Was that a different color from last time? It looks a little different. I don't. Appreciate.
You wanted to know about the look screen. When you undergo a transfer, you put your palm over the palm of your future body and look into its eyes. It's like looking into a mirror. But this part is crucial. The transfer can't happen without it. Mm-hmm. Then you're immersed into a kind of peculiar state when you see yourself from the side. On a signal, you push off with your palm and a mirror appears between you. And then you're alone again, in your new body.
Huh. That's interesting. That's some wonderful stuff right there. I feel like a new man. I swear that changed colors. I swear. Wait, before we start, I should... Okay, we'll fly into the sky. Where's that sword? Where's that magical sword? I just realized something. These flowers, they oddly look like the game's icon. They really do. Oh boy. That's totally not bad. Anyway, let's just go to the second pavilion. I don't feel sorry for the... for those, people that were used as bombs. I think this is what she was telling me in the previous episode?
I see you.
I think.
Opening.
I don't know, I'll just explain... I'll explain a few things, maybe. I don't know. Yeah, I feel sorry for the, uglies, I guess. Like, they lived a pretty bad life, I'll say that. Sucks for them. And they were used as bombs, pretty much. They just exploded and destroyed everything. Oh, we're going to the Matrix. Okay. I just realized I did not pick up the sword. Oh, okay. More loading. Okay. Man, I really love this game. I just love the lore and the gameplay. It's really cool. Tropical Island is the name of this thing, I think. Ah, okay. Luke screen. Collect 30. Oh. Okay. Use bombs to destroy gray blocks. Play. Make bomb explode. Okay. I think I got this. Okay. So the pink ones are the ones that we need to grab. So we can make okay. So we can make that's not good. That is not good. Now this is obviously gonna be a problem. Okay. I already hate this. I already hate this. Okay, let's just probably grab one of those on the road. Okay, there we go. I really hate this. Okay. That was a red block. There we are. I really hate this. Really? Fine. Okay. I already hate this! This is already difficult! This is getting really difficult. And I hate this. Okay. I had to do that. Like an idiot. Okay. I really need to clear this area, though. Let's break this real quick. Should probably put in the source. It's probably best if I put the bomb inside the source of these blocks. There we go. There we go. Fantastic. Man, I already hate this level. I'm gonna go lower it down. I really don't like this level. So what can I do with these? Black ones. Oh, they do that. They do stuff I don't want them to do. Okay. Okay. So it's being a big dum-dum and did something bad. Really bad. Okay. It's my business to sit this one right here. Fantastic. Oh, never memory of that thing. Okay. I really hate this. Well, that disappeared. Okay. I don't have a pick block. Okay, there we go. You know, I just have a tremendous amount of hate about this level. Or on this level. Okay. Okay. Ah, that seems good enough. Okay. Explosion! Oh boy. This place isn't looking that well. Yeah, this place has seen better. Probably just got all those. Pick that up. In my inventory. Put you. You up. Okay. This is really annoying. This is really annoying. Okay. It's probably best if I save two of these. Oh, you're getting damaged. That's good. Okay, well, is this area cleared? I think it is. Well, time to get out of here then. Alright. Well, aside from this mayhem, this game's really fun. I love it. I guess it makes it smirk. Oh. It makes it smirk and mad. Okay. It's probably best if I use this. That's a wrong block. There we go. That's not even the right place. There we go. Thank you. I don't think I will find any, bombs down here. Highly doubt it. I guess while I'm here, I can make some platforms. That's a baddie. Oh! Oh. Okay. That's fine. I hate this. A lot. Right, those blocks are broke. Good. Good. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. There we go. Alright, throw that in there. Pick that up. Throw that over there. Die. There's another one. Nope. Okay. Alright. Alright. Oh, what a lovely platform they made for me. It's a shame that has to go, though. Bye! Hate it. grab a little bit more bombs. And, okay. Okay. Jeez. Okay. Well, I almost died. That isn't really going to stop me. It really isn't. Okay, it's best if I just start throwing a lot more blocks. Okay. Set up the bomb real quick. Explode. Okay. Everything seems to be going well. Kind of. Alright, I guess I should decide to focus on throwing a whole lot more blocks. Hey, I won! Oh shoot, they're still around. Okay. There we go, Tropical Islands. It's finished. And the look screen is open. That's good, that's good. If this level was like this, I'm afraid that every single level, where the rest of the levels are gonna get a whole lot more harder and more challenging. Just the way I like it. Alright. There we go. Oh, sweet. It looks more dark. It really does look a whole lot more dark. Huh. Okay. Alright. Whee! Inhibish your touch the doof. Okay. Is there still no use for this, though?
I told you about the mirror between you and your former body. So, the mirror is turned on at the exact moment when your former body loses its original's right. It is concealed to keep you from seeing your face as it's put to death.
Oh.
The reason is that sometimes there are involuntary, mimicking contractions that resemble a smile. Obviously, that is something best left unseen.
Yeah, it's best. It's best if it's left unseen. Well, looks like the Baja is back. I can hear Desperatoxin. Alright. This is lovely. And we're back at this magic school bus of the Baja. Got myself in that. He bought himself a hat! A Santa Claus hat! That's son of a gun. Oh wait, is it a Santa Claus hat? It's... okay, it's not. It's not. It kinda looks like Santa Claus, though. Oh, okay.
If you got a death wish, why would you go there?
Where?
Oh, nowhere. Did you bring the flowers?
Here you go.
Here you go.
Attaboy. Here is your lens. My word is my bond. Mm-hmm. I'm not even going to ask what you want with it. I don't know what's going on in your head today. And I don't want to know.
Okay. Fine.
Tabaha, what do you know about this amusement park?
Stay away from it if you know what's good for you. Why do you think it's been fenced off? Because you shouldn't go in there. You'll be better off.
Fine. Jeez.
You must remember something. Tell me.
Yeah, tell me.
Think, man. I wasn't even around back then. There was an amusement park. And I guess someone must have exploded in there. Am I supposed to remember every explosion that ever happened? All I know is this damn poison-filled behemoth has been standing there for 20 years now. And nobody ever gave a crap. But suddenly you do. Why?
I'm curious. It's just so... strange.
Sure it is. But why do you care? What are you after?
Yeah.
I want to know why kids were undergoing transfers.
If they were, then there was a reason for it. Why does that even surprise you? It's just your regular mirror transfer.
But to Baja, they don't do transfers to kids.
To ordinary kids, they don't. These kids, they might not have been all that ordinary. I saw them once at an airport, with their teachers. I remember those kids standing there all pale and silent. It was forbidden to talk to them. So there.
To Baja, I've got a request for you.
Let me guess. You want me to dig up everything there is to know about the Gabera Garden, am I right?
Only what happened on the day of the explosion.
I just realized he's wearing...
Won't you just forget about this damn garden? Fine, I'll look into it.
Thanks, Tabaha.
I just realized he's wearing those,
I've got a rope.
Come on.
Last thing I need is to rack up airs and lose my wits. You know how vulnerable I am to that stuff. I may look calm and collected, but I've got crazy energy and passion for life.
You look just plain odd. Those glasses and nose.
These glasses are one of a kind.
Yeah, they
you
are.
You couldn't get them in your wildest dreams. But I got them at half price. That's because I'm a high roller, while you'll be chasing such luxuries all your life.
Please, don't forget about my request.
Baja is cool, I guess. Man, everything's starting to get really, really interesting. Oh, look, it's on Guts! A majestic eagle. I have no idea what type of eagle you're supposed to... I'm not really too familiar with species of eagles. But my robotic eagle friend... Did he lose his vest? I don't think he did. Might as well... Okay, frames are dying. See that he's back. Are we doing any conversation? Can I talk to you? Oh, look at your... Things are starting to get really suspicious right now. Alright, there we go.
Did you bring what I asked?
Yeah, actually first, help me understand
something.
What?
Oh, this is what I forgot.
I'm not sure.
Kids.
I think that it has to do with their nervous system, its development. Doing a transfer before it's fully formed is dangerous.
Got it.
Okay, that's what I forgot. The kid's being transferred.
The look screen as well?
The look screen and the lens. Let's connect them.
Disconnect the broken look screen. The input is inside, right behind it.
And then your eyes.
Okay. That's a little terrifying. That's a little terrifying. Just a little. There we go. She can see. She can see. I don't think she likes what she sees, though. You alright, Ida? Ida.
Well? How's your vision? Is it working?
Yes. I just...
What?
Nothing. It's fine. My eyesight is back, thank you.
What happened? Did you remember something?
Yes, actually, I did. I know now why I wasn't on that list.
Why weren't you?
I wasn't on staff. I would come to the Gerbera Garden with the kids and go back with the same group, meaning I wasn't a full-time employee.
Oh, so
I merely accompanied the children.
Oh, you were the teachers.
Baja said those kids were accompanied by teachers.
Those weren't teachers. It was psychologists that accompanied them. I'm a children's psychologist.
Ooh.
Why the need for a psychologist at an amusement park?
Yeah.
Enibish, this is not an amusement park at all.
Oh.
Those kids didn't come here for entertainment. They were gravely ill and were brought here for treatment. The Gerbera Garden is a clinic.
What were they treated for?
Some kind of psychological disorder.
Oh.
Quite severe, often fatal. But it's hard to say exactly what it was. I can't recall.
You mean the transfer was their therapy?
One part of it, yes. There was a whole set of measures. Body replacement was the final phase of the therapy. We also searched for parts and staged plays. They too were part of the treatment.
Plays? What kind of plays?
I remember this one episode. There was a vessel in front of the stage, kind of like a bathtub.
It's still there. I saw it.
Well, the kids would put embody parts in it. Each one would bring their own part from the pavilion and put it into the bathtub. And as it filled up, the MC would combine all the parts into a single body.
Huh.
And what happened then?
And then there was a cloud of steam. The body would be quickly, imperceptibly replaced with a young woman's, and she would pick up the lead. She would fight some giant head. And then something else would happen. I can't remember all the details.
And the cubes? Were they also part of the treatment?
The cubes, the flower beds, even the height of the pavilions. All were deliberate, mandatory elements of the same therapy. The Gerbera Garden was constructed specifically for those children. It was the only means of treating their illness, peculiar though it may have been.
The illness must have been peculiar to Madge.
It's still hard for me to imagine what it might have been, but those kids, they evoked more than just compassion. There was something else, some other complicated, ambiguous feeling.
Tabaha is right. Those kids were unusual.
Yes, and the amusement park was as well. Which means all arrivals had to be registered, myself included. I'll try to look for some kind of visitor's logbook or...
Or what?
Oh, she's beeping.
What is it?
My battery. It's nearly discharged.
Oh boy.
Bad news. I need you to make sense of all this.
In that case, Anubis, you'll need to play with those cubes some more.
Okay.
Sure thing, Ida. I'll play. Which pavilion?
A moment. Hands. Wrists. There, the fuel cell. 10th pavilion.
10th pavilion. Okay.
All right, I'm off.
Don't go anywhere. She can't really go anywhere, really. I mean, she just got it stuck inside this little vase thing. New task added. Okay. I should probably just drop this off then. Okay. Shrine. There we go. Alright. Well. Okay. Alright, so do I have any use for this yet? Lock this wire up. Like, do I have any use for this? I'm in shrine. Fine. Well, we're back to this place then. Man, I'm liking this story so far. It's really interesting. Oh boy. However, I'm getting a feeling this is not gonna end so happily. It's probably gonna end in horrible ways. Alright, well, let's jump right in. No questions asked. Let's go! So it looks like a desperate toxin cloud thing just blew up. Okay. Oh, we're done here. Alright. So let's go take a look at this bathtub I spoke of. What do you mean by bath? Oh, that thing, okay. That thing, alright. But I'm starting to think that, giant sphere over there is the source of all, of all the desperate toxin. That's like the, I guess that's where the explosion happened, I guess. That's what I think. Well, I'm at the 10th pavilion. Cloud Country. Kinda here. Oh.
The illness in those kids wasn't accidental. Before getting sick, there was something special about them, some kind of useful quality.
Oh, okay.
This quality allegedly gave them an intellectual advantage over grown-ups.
Hmm. Okay. That's interesting.
I see you. Go on in.
Finally. Okay. As Kevin messages me about something, I really don't want to look at it right now. Alright. Man, this game's really good, I'll say that. Alright. Time to go grab something. As Jonathan and Kevin message me on Steam, don't know if you can see it, but yeah, they're messaging me. Honestly, I just want to play my game. They're still messaging me. Okay, fine. Let's see. I'm seriously gonna take the time to look. Okay, so that's the battery. Hero 30, you'll keep again the battery, your kids, okay. Alright, so it's just like the very first one I did. Should be simple. Ooh, this music though. Oh boy, I fell. Oh, however, I don't think there's any bombs. There's barely any bombs, probably. Shikes. Nope, there's bombs. They're bomb types. Okay. Should be simple then. Okay. Alright. Ah, jeez. Nope, 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 nope. Stay. Okay. That's a little dangerous. Alright. Okay. Music, I swear. Hey man, can you? Jeez, okay. Well, I'm second terrible. I'm very bad right now. Okay. Or blow up. Okay. I think I'm freaking out a little bit too much. There we go. Okay. Alright. Oh shoot, I'm falling. Okay. Alright.
hit it. Okay. There we go. Don't wanna... I'm sorry, I have to sacrifice you. Oh. Well, thanks, I guess. Okay. I can set you... Right. Oh. Thank you. Exploding. Okay. Okay. I picked up something I wasn't supposed to pick up because I don't want that. Okay. And you're dead. Good. Okay. Pretty sure that does something I don't want it to do. Okay, well, you're not gonna fall down and die because I need to. Okay, let's see. Yeah, let's just right here. That's... Oh, well, there goes the yellow blocks. Totally do not need those. Okay. Yeah, you're dead. Okay. Should I best throw all these, like, right now before I lose them? Okay. Ooh, that's, this one falling. Explosion. Okay. Oh boy. Okay. Let's put you right there. Right, platform created. Well, I could throw the remaining in there. I'll just sit here and wait. Yeah, I won. Cow country is now my country. It's now fabulous Ramon country. All hail Ramon. Alright, so we've got the battery. Alright, game saved. That's good. This is going really well so far, actually. It's not like the other episodes where I screw up miserably. Where I had to search for nothing, really. Where I just search for something, but I fail at it. Does it mean it's a little bit more bigger? Yeah, whatever. But yeah, obviously, this looks like an area that,
I found out what special quality those kids had. They had exceptionally developed visual perception. Visual and aesthetic. For them, the shape, color, and the like of surrounding objects was of critical importance. Some things were beautiful in their eyes, others the definition of ugly. And here's the kicker. They were always in consensus. But it was that very ability that ultimately became their blight. The particulars, however, I still do not know.
Uh-huh. Okay. Well, yeah, that spot with those odd flowers that look like the logo of this game, and what the thing looks like inside an Ongot. That's obviously where the explosion happened. Yeah. Oh wow! Hey, that sky actually looks different. Huh. Okay. All right. Well, time to go do stuff. I really like this game stuff. That's an eagle. It's my eagle, though. I don't think it's my eagle. Oh, boy. Okay, I'll jump over that. Ah! Hello?
Did you bring the battery?
Here it is. Let's replace it.
Yes, let's replace it, indeed.
But you'll need to switch me off first.
Okay.
All right.
Here come the shakes again.
Well, no way around that.
Yep. Sadly.
Shut me down.
See you in a minute.
Oh boy. Yeah, I feel sorry. Oh, I feel sorry about that. Okay. I think it's in here. I need the free slot. Oh, okay. There we go. I feel so sorry though. You're right, Ida. Okay.
Two attacks in one day.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
I'm breaking records.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Well, did you find out anything?
Yes.
Did you find your number?
My number? Oh, no, not yet. But I did learn what the children were treated for. Remember I told you that the shape of objects was important to them?
I do.
Is it blind, I guess?
Well, their illness was called morphophobia. Fear of a shape.
Oh!
Or to be more precise, an aversion to it.
What kind of shape?
Also, shut up, phone.
The human body. They couldn't stand the sight of a human body. That was their disease.
What do you mean that they couldn't stand it?
Yeah.
They would literally get sick, vomiting at the sight of any person. Their teachers, doctors, passers-by, their own parents, even seeing each other in the mirror.
What did they dislike so much about the human body?
We never did find the answer. The children weren't able to articulate their feelings. First of all, they were really young. And secondly, they were unable to communicate at all with anyone. Any attempt at communication caused suffering and psychogenic vomiting.
What an unusual disease.
Very unusual.
Yes. Which is why the treatment was likewise unusual. Now I know the purpose behind those strange activities. Playing with cubes, collecting parts, and so on.
So why were they assembling an embody on stage?
Yeah.
To cultivate in the children a positive association with the sight of a human body. They were using those bits to independently assemble a fairy tale character. A positive character. And thanks to their efforts, a young woman would take the stage. The defender of beauty, protecting a blossoming garden from a wicked witch.
The witch symbolized ugliness?
Evidently. Beauty would triumph over ugliness, and the children rejoiced at their involvement in bringing about a happy end. Bit by bit, their repulsion toward the human body was thus dislodged from their psyches, replaced by a new mindset, which filled the human body with beauty and goodness.
That's nice.
But why did they need to go through a transfer?
The transfer anchored this mindset. All the emotional experience obtained at the Gravera Garden would anchor only in a new body. Otherwise, the therapy had no effect.
I see. And the cubes? What was their purpose?
The cubes have an extremely simple shape. Playing in the pavilions blunted the kids' excessive sensitivity.
Mm-hmm.
Their psyches were being simplified so as to start sewing in them trivial categories. Good and evil, beauty and ugliness. Because their perception developed in an anomalous manner, the kids saw the world of shapes very differently, in a way that grown-ups could never understand. And there was no other way to save their lives other than to make them simpler.
I'm still having trouble understanding.
I'm not.
Hold on. Meyer. Hennebish. My name is Ida Meyer.
Ida, okay.
You remembered?
Ida Meyer.
I found a journal. It contains my data. Here. Ida Meyer, age 26, city of Geneva. My personal number. And a date.
Oh.
August 15th, 2058. What year is it, by the way?
76.
Whoa. So, I'm a psychologist from Geneva,
mm-hmm.
and I've been lying in Mongolian soil for 18 years.
In a candy box. And not in soil, but in sand.
Very well, in sand. And now I'm in a flower vase, trying to verify my number. Only, damn it.
Ooh.
What?
It's not working. The network interface, I can't get online.
I guess the vase doesn't integrate with the web.
Enibish, there's another network terminal underneath the TV. It's functional, only without power. If you can power it up, I'll be able to get online.
Okay.
I'll try. Let's see how the wiring is done.
Okay. This is going good. Okay. It's the wiring. I know exactly what to do. Scrap that. Oh, I need all of them. Okay. The problem is I just don't remember exactly where the boxes are at. I don't know where they are. Okay, well, that's one of them. So, finally, these finally have a purpose. Okay. So here, Unguts in the background. Okay. So I think there's one up here as well. I think. Alright. If I can even find it. I'll say that box is to have a purpose. Okay. Alright. Yay, we did something. Anything? No. It's all solid bad. Ah! Okay. This is. Okay.
Whee!
Okay. Where did I put it, though? Oh, there we are. Need to activate it? Do I need to press some buttons? Nope. Okay. New task. Use the remote to switch on the terminal. Okay. Okay. What remote exactly? Not exactly sure where you're. Not sure where exactly this remote's at. So you kind of have to. You kind of have to tell me where a few things are at, because I honestly have no idea where the remote's at. Well, looks like this is another episode of Searching for Something. Oh boy, hey, look, knife. Okay. Nothing. Anything? Nothing. I was listening to some tunes while I searched everything. Nothing. Huh, well, that's dirty. Okay. Is that it? That can't be it. What's this? What if what would happen if your neighbor's accumulation container were to spill over? Find out how the city's evacuation service, as well as the ordinary citizens, self-control risk groups to prevent new desperate toxin emissions. Purple feelings. Nicknamed 10, Jim leads a pretty unique life. Leads a pretty unique life. We spend a mere 2 days per month in an active state. Okay. Totally normal. I hear you, Unguts. Shut up, please. Is the remote in here? Okay, where is the remote? Where is the remote? Excuse me, where's the remote? Is this the remote? Is this the remote they speak of? There's nothing in here. Nothing. Okay, well, I guess this is gonna be another adventure of Ramon traveling literally everywhere just to find one single item. Yeah, I think this is what this episode's gonna be like. Finding a darn remote. Use the remote to switch on the terminal. The problem is, man, I don't know where this remote is. I really have no idea where this remote's at. I'm not feeling like we'd be searching everywhere for this. Hmm. Again, I could be just neat. I swear, if this is... Okay. Are you the remote? Okay. Anything? Wow, okay, I think I'm just gonna be searching everywhere, looking for one little item. Don't go to bed. All this just for one remote.
Did you power up the terminal?
Not yet.
I'm looking for our remote. Doesn't really exist anywhere at this point. Stone medallion. Where is this remote that they speak of? I really can't find this remote. It's just like in real life. You can't find a freaking remote. Okay. Alright. Is that it? No, that's just something else. Okay. Anything? Just Rubik's Cube. Stuff. Are you? No, this is not what I wanted. Nope. Continue. Yep. Thank you. Right. And you go to bed. Okay. Go ahead, Anna, bitch. Take a nap. Just take a wonderful nap. It's not like you just wake up. Thank you for waking up. Seriously, though, where is this remote? I can just hear people yelling. Just yelling. About how I can't find this remote. I'll take that with me, though. Thank you. Remote. I bet you don't think you even have a remote. Shut up on guts. Is this a remote? Are you a remote? Is even a remote? Am I a remote? Yeah, I don't think there's even a remote anywhere. I think I'm about to just say, okay, I'll be back, I guess. Yeah, I'm about to do that. Really don't want to do that, but I have to do it. Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna have to do that. Anyway. Yeah. Yeah, definitely. So anyway, yeah. I've been PimpShrimp. And if you like this video, like, favorite, and maybe even subscribe if I'm even that worthy. But yeah, this has been Cradle. And as always, praise the moose.